Dear students, welcome to Study Bus, the online study channel. Today we are going to study environmental studies for class 2. Let's have the overview. Chapter number is 15. Chapter name is Learning About Time. The concept is knowing the time, days in a week and months and year. We shall learn about time, about 24 hours, which makes one day, and 7 days makes one week. 4 weeks make 1 month and 12 months make 1 year. A day is divided into morning, noon, afternoon, evening and night. So how do we know the time? We do a lot of different things throughout the day. We wake up at a particular time, go to school at a particular time and go to bed at a particular time. So how do we know what the time is? The sun tells us the time. The position of the sun in the sky helps us to know the time of the day. The sun rises in the morning. Our day begins at this time. The sun is over our head in the sky at noon. The sun sets in the evening. The period of the day between morning and evening is known as afternoon. After the sun sets, it is known as night. Our day ends at night. Clocks tell us the time. Clocks tell us the exact time. They help us to give a number to a particular time in the day. Clocks usually have two hands, which move to show the time. The number at which the shorter hand points is the hour, and the number at which the longer hand points shows the minute. You can see a clock in the image which is showing the time 7:30. Zoom in. Did you know? One day is divided into seconds, minutes and hour. There are 60 seconds in a minute. There are 60 minutes in an hour. There are 24 hours in a day. During the day, when the clock strikes 12, it is called noon or midday. The time before noon is known as AM and the time after noon is known as PM. When the clock strikes 12 at night, it is called midnight. Days of the week. There are 7 days in a week. Each day has a name. A calendar helps us to know what day of the week it is. Look at the pictures below to find out the names of days of the week. So, you can see Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday and Saturday. Weeks and months. You know the 7 days make a week. Let us understand that. 4 weeks plus 2 or 3 extra days is equal to 1 month. And 12 months is equal to 1 year. A calendar also helps us to know what month of the year it is. Look at the following picture. You can see the names of the months in a year. Can you find out how many months there are in a year? So, months of the year images you can see in the picture. January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November and December. Year. The previous picture shows that there are 12 months in a year. All the months do not have the same number of days. Some months have 30 days and some have 31 days. February is the shortest month, which has 28 days only. In some years, there are 29 days in February. Such years are called leap years. There are 365 days in a year. In a leap year, there are 366 days. Fun learning. Do you know which months have 30 days and which have 31? Here is a fun way to learn it. Look at the picture of the fist. Begin with the right knuckle. Start saying the names of the months while counting the knuckles and gaps. The months that fall on knuckles have 31 days. The months that come on gaps have less than 31 days. Can you now write the names of months that have 31 days and the months which have less than 31 days? So here we have completed the chapter. Now let's have a look on the textbook exercise. Take the correct answer. 7 days make a week. The shortest month in a year is February. The number of months in a year is 12. During the night, when the clock strikes 12, it is midnight. The third month of a year is March. Now, who am I? I have 7 days. I am a week. Number 2, I come at a time when it is 12 on the clock during the day. I am a noon. Number 3, I tell the time so that people are not late for work. I am a clock. Number 4, I keep a record of days and months. People hang me on the wall or keep me on their desks. I am a calendar. Number 5, I come before Monday. I am Sunday. So here we have completed the textbook exercise along with the chapter. Hope you have understood this. And if you have any problem, please watch the video again. Thanks for studying with StudyBuzz.